JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFD's daily market review for May the 22nd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the dollar traded higher against all but two of the other G10 currencies on Thursday and during the Asian morning Friday. It gained the most versus NOK, CHF and the Canadian dollar in that order, while it lost some ground only against the Japanese yen and the British pound. Now, the strengthening of the dollar and the yen suggests that risk appetite softened yesterday, but the fact that the Swiss franc was among the main losers points otherwise. So in order to get a better picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we will turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, most major EU and US indices traded lower, with the negative morale rolling into the Asian session today. Both Japan's Nikkei and China's Shanghai Composite slid 0.80% and 1.60% respectively, while Hong Kong's Hang Seng was the biggest loser, tumbling 5.02% as China's National People's Congress confirmed that it plans to pass a bill establishing an enforcement mechanism for ensuring national security for Hong Kong in response to last year's violent pro-democracy protests. Ahead of that, US President Donald Trump warned that the US would react strongly if China proceeds with national security laws for Hong Kong, after accusing the world's second largest economy over disinformation in order to hurt his re-election chances, and after US senators decided unanimously to pass a bill which makes it hard for Chinese firms to stay listed in the US. The new frictions between the US and China may have revived fears that the two nations are unlikely to secure a final trade deal and could even jeopardize the already agreed Phase 1 accord. That, combined with the infected cases from the coronavirus hitting a fresh daily record, may have been the main reasons behind the change from risk on to risk off. That said, that still does not change our overall view, at least at the moment. We still believe that the prospect of more fiscal and monetary stimulus around the globe and the fact that headlines suggest that we are closer to a virus drag may allow risk assets to rebound again. What's more, even if infections have accelerated strongly, the overall virus curve appears much flatter than a couple of months ago. Thus, even if equities extend yesterday's slide for a while more, we will still see decent chances for a reversal higher. Having said all that, though, we will remain careful as additional tensions between the world's two largest economies and or further acceleration in virus cases may keep a lid to equities and risk-linked assets and perhaps bring us back to square one. Now, we also had a Bank of Japan emergency meeting overnight. Despite Japan's national core CPI rate tumbling to minus 0.2% year-over-year from plus 0.4%, the bank kept its policy unchanged but announced the start of a new small business lending program. In any case, this passed unnoticed by the financial community. As for today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK retail sales for April. The headline rate fell to minus 18.1% from minus 5.1% instead of sliding to minus 16% as the forecast suggested, while the core rate fell to minus 15.2% month over month from minus 3.8%. Forecast was for the core rate to slide to -15%. Anyhow, the pound barely reacted to the release, as this barely changes anything around the Bank of England policy expectations. Remember that the bank appears ready to expand its QE as early as in June, with several officials noting that negative interest rates are also on the table. Now, later in the day, we get the minutes from the latest ECB meeting, as well as Canada's retail sales for March. We expect the ECB minutes to confirm that policymakers remain willing to adjust all their instruments as necessary, while Canada's headline sales are forecast to have fallen 10% month over month after rising 0.3% in February. The core rate is anticipated to have rebounded to -5% month over month from -15.6%. We also have one speaker on today's agenda, and this is ECB Executive Board member Philip Lane. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning more about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 7 o'clock AM GMT time. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, a greater weekend, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again next week.
JFT, just fair and direct.